All right, here we are. We got the music queued up. We're gonna get moving. Let me know if you're not able to hear me. All right, got my chair, got my booster, got my weights. Make sure you got your water bottle handy. We're gonna start with a nice deep breath in. Lift it up, exhale down. Good, and again. It up and down. One more time. Lift up. Draw those abs in and up. Bring it down. Great job. Now I'm going to round that spine, nodding my head, bringing it down, and then bring it back up. I'm only rounding about down to the mid to low back. Bring it up. Restack to the top. And again, keep those shoulders relaxed. Bring it up. Good. Keep those abs lifted up and in the whole time here to support your back. One more. Bring it up. Good work. All right. We're going to push right up, left up, right up. Stand balanced on those feet, trying to find a balanced place here on the floor, and press, press. Those hands start at the shoulders, and they press right overhead. It's push, push, push. So glad you're joining me this morning. Press. Happy August. We're well into August, but we're feeling it too, aren't we? That heat. You got four, three, two. Press both up. See how it feels. Bring them down. And again, push them both up. Circle out and around. Two more. Push. Down. Good. You're modifying, right? If this hurts your shoulders, you're modifying. Now, bring those feet right in, right under the hips. And we're going to step to the right. In. Right. And in. Now, I'm shifting my weight. Not sure if I can trust that board, so I'm going to scoot over. Shifting your weight out to that right leg, only in so far as you can support it. Keep your weight more balanced, centered, if you feel like, yeah, that doesn't feel so hot. Take it out and hold it there, right there. Good. Feet are about shoulder to hip distance apart. We're going to send the hips back, back, straight back. Up. You go. Just think through the hips for now. Send them back. We're just warming up. Doesn't have to be low. Just definitely send the hips back. Push and up. From the side, push the hips back and up. I'm just thinking with my hips here. Of course, using the abs as support. Stand it up. Push the hips back. Stand it up. Good. I want to keep that chest lifted, my eyes out in front on the horizon. One more. Stand up. Great. Bring those feet back in. This time we'll step out to the left. Just a little weight shift. Soften that knee to catch you. Good. Putting the foot down. Toe ball heel. Toe ball heel. Push it off. That feels a little different for me today on the left side. So I'm going to pay attention, make sure that that leg has got me. Good, keep it going. That's it. You're giving me four more. You can certainly slow that gesture down if that feels too fast. Right there. Let's bring those feet back in underneath us, between shoulder and hip distance apart. This time, as you send the hips back, really focus on that chest. Reach the arms out in front of you. When you send the hips back, stand up. Reach the arms out in front. Stand up. Reach back. Stand up. There we go. Stand up. Reach, float the arms forward. You got it. Up. Squeeze. Reach. Come back. backside. Thinking low abs. Up. Reach. Now hold it down for a count of 8, 6. Chest is proud. Stand yourself up. Reach out again. Hold it for 8. 4, 3, 2, and 1. Stand yourself up. Great job. Now just the arm gesture, please. Just your reach the arms out. Pull them back. Thinking through your elbows here. Reach. Pull them back. Pull them back. I'm keeping those elbows low so that as I pull them back, they're sliding right past my waist. Palms are staying up. Knees are not locking. Reach back. There we go. All right, we can play a little bit more with these arms. Let's flip the palms down. Now pull the elbows back so they're about shoulder height, maybe a little bit lower. I'm going to say definitely lower. And reach. Pull the elbows back. Let's play with the footwork on this. Step back. Upper traps, you're gonna know it pretty soon. It's gonna get really tight and uncomfortable up around your neck. So avoid using those muscles. Instead, use those muscles right below the shoulder blades. Squeeze. Elbows are just below shoulder height. 4. Knees. Now go ahead and get a drink of water. That was your warm-up. Get a drink of water. I'm going to get my weights set up. Making sure that my hips are slightly higher than my knees when I sit. There we go. All right. Oh, I feel so far away. I'm going to move forward a little bit. Alright, if you're just joining me, welcome, welcome. Welcome to Idaho. I'm in Donnelly, Idaho this week for a little R&R. And you are the beneficiary of the beautiful view. I'll show you the lake when we're done. Feet flat, out in front. Alright, hinge forward. We know this one. Now stay right here. I want you to rest into your arms so that the backs of the arms and shoulders are what's supporting you here in this posture. Welcome. Press it back, press it back, up to tall, and hinge. Thanks for joining me this morning. I would call out your name, but I don't have my glasses on. And hinge. I'm so glad you're here. Chest is proud. Push it away. If your friends can't join us this morning, definitely tell them that we'll be online here and they can catch up with us anytime. And it's hinge. Feel the backs of the arms. Press back. It's like you're doing a little mini push-up here. As you lower, you're supporting the body weight, and then you're pushing it up right from here. All right, are you feeling that? I hope so. And push, push, push. Try it again. Hinge forward, bending those elbows. Keep those elbows close to your side as you work. You're gonna get a little more tricep focus there. And push, push. Good. Straight up and tall. Bend. Keep that chest proud. There we go. How about two more? Hinge forward. And push. Last one. Hinge. Can you believe this dictionary Deep breath up. Exhale down. One more time. Now in the age of dictionary on your phone, these poor large dictionaries are kind of fossilized creatures. All right, I've got my canned goods. These are our weights today. This is really the best thing I could find. I wasn't gonna haul anything huge with me. But I'm gonna bring those weights to my shoulders. Point your elbows out in front. Now your job is to extend the arm as far as it will go, just out in front of you, okay? So I'm firing into those triceps again. A little bit of bicep to come back in to the shoulders. Really find extension through the back of the arm. Curl in, reach away. Curl in, and reach away. Curl it in, reach it away. There we go. Now, I'm gonna bring just the right arm up, point my elbow a little higher, press the weight up, bend it down. Press the weight up, bend it down. Good, stay with it. Shake up these refried beans. You ready? We're going to take it a little faster on that right. So push, bend, push, bend. Sitting tall. Feel balance on your hips, balance on your feet. Exhale. Six, five. You can take these slower if you want. Two and one. Bring that weight all the way down. We're going over to the left arm. Elbows aiming a little bit higher. Notice that weight is right on my shoulder. Extend, extend. Push it away. Shaking up those beans. Push, push. Nice job. Keep the breath alive. Do not hold your breath while you're working out, while you're lifting anything. In fact, I can't think of a good time to hold your breath at all unless you're underwater. Four, three, here's two, and one. Let's bring that weight all the way down, all the way down. There it is. Balance those weights on your legs, all right? I want to test my core by keeping the core engaged, keeping those legs as still as possible, with the goal of not spilling the beans. That's where we're going. We're gonna reach those arms out nice and long. Now I really need to tune into my abs, draw them up and in order to keep my legs stable. Whoops, you see how easily that happens. All right, there we are. Reach. Okay, now I'm gonna circle those arms. Very small. Now I'm gonna slow it down. Slowing it down so that I've got better control. When in doubt, slow it down, make the gesture smaller until you feel like, okay. And this is a true test, isn't it? It's a true test. If you drop those cans, you've got a little more focus work to do. Find those abs. Try to relax your shoulders as they go around in a circle. That's a trick. Four, three, two, and one. Now, sweep the arms in front, palms down, palms up, sweep them out to the sides again. Stay tall. Palms down, into the middle. Palms up, out, east and west. Open the arms, bring them in, floating arms, floating arms. Keep the work in the center of the body, keep it in the core. Drawing that navel back towards your spine and then lifting it up towards your rib cage. You're trying to draw, that one's really getting slippery. Open, correct those weights anytime. You're gonna do one more sweep in with the arms. And one more sweep out. There we go. Relax. Now, relax. Hands on the weights. There we go. Let's try a few bicep curls. Right arm, switch to left. All right, so you hear the beat there. We're gonna match it in just a moment, but first, get a sense of your range. Make sure you're not swinging the weights, especially as we speed up. Shoulders are down and back. Find that place. Mid back, the shoulder blades and below, where there's a slight bit of tone. those shoulder blades down and in control. I don't want to hike the shoulders up at this point. Okay, so I'm feeling that energy definitely in my mid-back. Keep it there. Let's add some tempo. Some of us, and just add some reps to it. Some moving is better than no moving, right? Four more. Four, three, two, and one. Beautiful job. I'm going to set those weights down for a moment while we work with the lower body for a minute. Let's add some stretching to this, all right? So plant that right foot down. A little more centered. I'm going to hug that left knee up and in, holding at the shin or under the thigh, whatever works for you. And then I want you to start to point, flex the ankle. Now I'm holding the leg up with my biceps. I'm keeping those shoulders trained down my back, just like when we did the bicep curl. And then I'm trying to pull my posture up by pulling on the leg. So the chest lifts, the knee lifts. Together as though they're trying to connect in the center. Circle that ankle now. Circle it around. Circle it around. There we go. And around. And breathe. Two. And one. Good. Go the other way. And you're thinking, well, this is supposed to be a stretch. Nice and relaxing. Not so. You're really hitting every angle of that ankle. This is work. You really have to push it around a bit. So this can become fatiguing. Ankle at the shin. That's a good thing. Two and one. Yay. Go ahead and put that down. Extend that left heel out in front, the same side. We're still on that left leg. Make sure that foot is aligned with the hip. I'm going to support on my right thigh and hinge forward to stretch the back of the thigh. Woo-wee. There you go. And sit up tall. And if the last time you stretched this was with me, well then it's been too long. I want you to stretch this every day, every day. Sit in your chair. I know you're sitting, you're eating, right? So take a moment, assess the tension in those legs, and really go for a stretch. Unfortunately, if we stretched yesterday, probably right back to where you were. But as the muscle learns to lengthen, bit better, you'll get to that stretch a little sooner. Not to mention, your pain threshold improves over time. So that'll get you a little farther as well. I did say the P word. Okay, so you know where that pain threshold is. You're knocking on that door, but you're not crossing the threshold, right? And some of us can handle a little more discomfort than others, and that's okay. No judgment there. Just knowing where you are, knowing what you can handle, knowing what you feel, first off, that's a big challenge some days. Now, hold that stretch, pull those abs up and in, again, right under your rib cage. Stay right there. My toes are pulling back towards me. Now, slowly help yourself up and plant that left foot nice and firmly. All right, whoever thought that stopping a stretch is a rest, but it is, isn't it? Now, a little more centered with the left foot. Let's hug that right knee in and up, getting a nice deep flexion on the hip and the knee. If that's too intense, hold on under the thigh, okay? Try not to let your body posture round towards the stretch, okay? In fact, lift it up. Pull the knee towards your shoulder or your chest and the chest towards the knee. Tall. I'm going to really plant that left foot down, draw my abs up and in, and take a few deep breaths. And again, breathe. Starting with the ankle, point, flex, point, flex. Now is not the time to stop breathing. Keep it going. You might change it a little bit since our tempo has changed. But just keep that breath alive. It doesn't have to match any particular rhythm. Whatever your rhythm is what's appropriate. Point and flex. ankle. So you're really working the muscles of the ankle while you're stretching. It takes an effort to get into that stretch, those places where you don't always focus. Let's go the other direction. Circle that ankle around. I want this to get good and tired. Chest is proud. I'm going to keep my shoulders back and down as I hinge forward. Make sure you're on your chair so that you can feel the sits bones there and you're not going to slip forward. That's really important that you're solid on your chair. Good. Stay with me. And hinge. Yep. Using those arms is as much with as much support as you need. Hinge forward. Find your stretch. You find your limit. Right leg is going to feel different, probably, than the left. That's normal, but we do strive to find balance, right and left. I'm going to hold this one now. Hold it forward. I'm trying not to round my back as I do the stretch. I want to keep it nice and straight. Chest proud, shoulders down, and breathe with me. You find your pain threshold. Don't cross it. It's okay to be a little bit uncomfortable in a stretch. Breathe. Thursday will feel better. Thursday will feel better. And sit it up. Sit it up. Great job. Woo! Deep breath lift. Lower down. Just finding our spacing again. From the ribs up and down. One more. Lift. Really fill up the rib cage. Exhale down. What do you say we do a little bit of twist here? Plant your feet. Let's hold on to a dumbbell or a weight in our right hand. Reach that out in front, right there. I'm going to wrap my left arm around my waist. I'm going to pull that right elbow back and twist. And reach forward. And pull around to twist. Now, trying to keep my feet and hips in the same place the whole time. And reach forward. Twists and turning. Really important skill to develop and maintain. For your safety when you're driving, you need to be able to turn around and see behind you. Forward. Pull the elbow back. Forward. Pull it back. Two more times. Rotate from the ribs, shoulders, and head. One more. All right. That way, just let it swing a little bit. Make sure you're not going to run into anything. Safety is our first priority. Just let it swing. There you go. All right, we're going to take it over to the other side. Reach it out. Wrap your right arm around your waist. Palm is down. You're going to bend that left elbow. Follow it around and reach forward. There we go. Pull the elbow back and forward. Pull it back and forward. Back and forward. Pull it back and forward. Jones, come here. What have you got? Pull it back. Forward. Good. Feeling mid back. Mid back, right below the shoulder blades. Pull it back. Forward. Good, good. Here, Jones. Now, let's just swing that arm. Make sure it's in control. Your body posture is nice and upright and strong. You're not going to swing your arm into anything, so be careful there. Swing that arm. Sit tall. I'm going to scoot over just a little bit. That chair. Three, two, and one. Good. Go ahead and place that can down. Grab a drink of water. Here. hamstring. Your chair back's here. Mine's a little low. It's just a patio chair, but hopefully yours is right around the hip zone. Right around the hip zone. I'm going to use a weight as an option. This is optional. Just that. Left foot forward, right foot back. There we go. Now, before I go anywhere, I'm going to pick up my right heel. Bend that knee in under the hip. And then tilt my pelvis back. Alright, so I'm trying to pull that pubic bone up towards my sternum while not dropping the chest or the ribs down. Okay, they stay put. Now I'm going to undo that stretch. Notice how the hips tip forward. Okay, but this hasn't changed. I'm going to rock the hips under me again by peeling up that right heel, bending the knee in, and then release the stretch. Let me move my arm so you can see my hips. Tilt back, and then tilt forward. Use those abs to help the gesture along. Pull those hips underneath you. Reach it back. Anybody getting a stretch for that right hip and quad? Pull it forward. It's almost like a tail tuck. Reach it back. Good. Tilt, tilt, tilt. Keep it proud through the chest. Reach that heel back, and again, tilt, scoop, scoop and hollow right through here. Now, this is dual purpose. This is stretching the hip and quad. It's also training that core, those abs, to help move the hips. So you're developing core strength and release. All right, now keep that leg back. We're gonna bend both knees and up. Now we get into the resistance piece of this. Weight back in that left hand. Give me a curl and press. Bring it down and elongate. Try it again. Curl, press it up. Bring it down and all the way down. Now I'm holding onto the chair initially, but then I'm going to let go. Check my balance. Squeezing upper inner thighs to help me stabilize. Doesn't have to be my range. You do what feels best for those knees. And up. Beautiful. Now we're going to step forward, feet side by side, and shake those hips. As I turn around, shake those hips. Okay? Now the right foot's forward, left foot's back. We're going to stretch that left hip flexor now, just like we did on the other side. Gesturing with the pelvis. All right, so tip that pelvis back by pulling that left knee in under the hip, picking up that left heel, and then release the stretch by straightening the leg back behind you. The front leg doesn't do a whole lot here. It's just here for balance. Thank goodness it's there. And reach it back. Tilt and curl. Chest is proud. Keep those shoulders out of the equation. Keep them easeful. And reach. Breathing, that tail tuck feeling, right? And then reach it back. Watch my back leg. It's bending, the heel peels up, and then the hips go back. Now the hips go forward. Reach that heel away. Scoop and hollow. Take your time, it's a stretch. It's a stretch. Back. Good. I'm also striving to keep those hips very squared with the wall that I'm facing. Especially when you get tight there in the hips, they'll begin to rotate. You won't even realize it unless you're paying attention. Reach it away. We're going to do one more stretch. Curl the hips back. Good. Nice and strong right here in the abs. And then reach it away. I'm going to pick up my weight in the right hand, and we're going to do our lunge combo with the upper body. So it's going to be a curl, a press. Weight as high as it makes sense for your shoulder. straight down, straight up. You feel like you're moving forward and back. Then assess your lunge. Make sure both knees bend at the same time. Lift. Remember, your lunge does not have to be as deep as my lunge. I just want to make sure that I'm on solid footing here. I'm going to do two more. You can take a break or keep moving. Up. Bend. Lower. One more time. Curl. Up. Down. And open. Yay. Stepping forward. Great job. Set those weights aside. Feet a little bit wider than hip distance apart. Send your hips back. I'm in my squat position. We're going to stir the hips around to stretch them out a bit. So push to the right, pull forward, push to the left, stop in the middle, go the other way, left, scoop around to the right, and center. Let's go again to the right. Push, tilt. Responding to what I'm doing with my arms. It's okay that they shift a little bit. Don't have to keep them locked in any place. Four. I really want you to feel that in the tummy. Two. And one. Great job. Run those arms. A little bit of knee bounce. This is your flush out. This is where you get to relax. Get that blood flowing again. Let's work those delts, the chest a little bit more. Keep your foot stance right where it is. Knees are softened. We're going to bring the arms up here to your upright position. Goal post. Palms facing out. Now just keep those hands in that same position as you pull them in. Now they face the midline, right? I'm only going to pull in until I'm aligned with my shoulders. I'm not going to try to squeeze everything together. And open. Nice and wide. I want you to think of the work going both directions. So going forward, you're using the front of the shoulder. As you go back, you're using the back of the shoulder. Pull, pull from the front, breathe, back, squeeze that mid back, shoulder blades and below, not above, and open. Shoulder blades and below. That means the shoulder blades are gently pulling down the back while you open the arms. Knees are softened. Split stance, one foot in front, one foot behind, but even weight distribution. Lift, 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 lift. Avoid white knuckling with your hands. If you need to, unlace the fingers so that you're not gripping with intensity. Three, two, and one. Gently release the arms down. Woo-wee. Open those arms up and external rotation so your thumbs are pointing either out to the sides or a little bit behind you. Lift that chest. Pulse. Okay? So I've lifted my chest, but I'm keeping my ribs up against the body. So I'm not arching my back to get this work done. I'm keeping it correct. Keeping it aligned. Reach those thumbs. Up. 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 Keep in mind that your arms do not have to be behind you. Okay? If that's too far, then move them forward. Yes, but you're still working those shoulders. Breathe. Try not to use your neck muscles or your upper traps. In other words, we're still reaching those shoulder blades down the back. Breathe. Three, two, one, and relax. Woo, roll those shoulders out. Stay with it. Take a few deep breaths. Whoopsie, my camera's shifting. We're gonna stretch those shoulders out now. Opportunity to fight that gravity from your tummy, pull it up and in. Now now place the hands on the chair. My knees are still softened, right? Because I don't want to lose that straight line of my spine. If you have to round forward to reach your chair like this, then bend those knees until you can straighten out your spine again. We want a straight, correct spine. Breathe. Now, we're going to slowly straighten the knees and slowly bend. Now, straighten is relative, right? It doesn't have to be perfectly straight, but just stretch. Straighten until you're stretching to that point where you can still breathe well, are a little uncomfortable, okay? And ideally, this stretch will get a little bit longer with each successive repetition. And pull it up, scoop those abs up and in, stretch, bend, elongate. Now match that posterior leg stretch, that hamstring stretch, with an abdominal tone, okay? So just as far as you're stretching, we're also engaging those abs. Woo! Keeping us lifted and light. Four more, and soften. Are you getting longer? Soften. Two, soften, feeling balance. Right there, soften the knees. Now, keep your support on your chair. Pull your ribs up to the sky as you drop your head and tail. Bring it down to a nice flat spine. Now the shoulders are gonna slide around a little bit when you do this. Let them do that. Inhale, come down, slide the shoulders back down back. As you flex up, they're gonna slide open. And as you come down, draw them down your back again to their natural neutral posture. Flex up, pull the ribs up, bring it down. And when you float your ribs up, avoid pushing really hard with your hands. Keep them lighter. Instead, pull up to the sky. Bring it down. That way we're not stressing the wrists. Pull it up, flex, tuck your tail. How many times have we done that today? Quite a few. Hoping that pelvis is getting more and more mobile. Let's do one more. Flex it up. Be light. And release. Right there. Good. Place your hand right on your thighs. Help yourself back up to an upright, tall posture. Let's take a deep breath up. And down. Good. As you float the arms up, open wide through the shoulders. Now slide the shoulders down and then the elbows and then the hands. All right, I'm gonna stop that music. I'm gonna show you my view. Hang on. Okay, let's see. Oh, thank you for joining me. Is it Sharon? I don't, or is it Shireen? I don't have my glasses, but I'll certainly take a look in a moment. But this is where I am. I'm in Idaho. I hope you can see that well, but this is our lake cabin and our beach is down there just over that bluff, but feeling very lucky to be here. And I'm so glad you were here to join me this morning. I will be back on Thursday, same time, Thursday, 9 o'clock. So spread the word, call your friends. I'd love to see you live. I really would. This would be very, very fun. So be in touch. Okay. Thanks for being here. Be well. Hydrate, and stay cool in those hot hours. Alrighty. Goodbye.